Good morning children, welcome back. Today we are going to do English grammar, chapter number 9. It is the great stone phase 1. Okay, we are going to see today, and it is from the book Honeydew. Okay, so first of all we will see the meaning of that. Number 1 is immense. Immense means huge. Number 2, enormous means very big. Gigantic means immense. Prophecy means statement that tells what will happen in the future. Pensive means thoughtful. Inhabitant means dwellers. Sympathies means feelings. Beheld means saw. Renowned means famous. Proclaim means announce. So here there is a story about the great stone face. Great stone face. Here it is shown, the author has shown that many people believe and they make different stories. Okay, they make different prophecies according to their thought. Okay, and here is a story about a mountain which is made up of different parts of the rock, and when anyone see the mountain from very far, the mountain could appear as a face of a human being. Okay, and if anyone go near the mountain, the face could not be seen, but from the very far anyone can see the mountain or the particular the rock. It could be compared to as a face of human being. So in this story there are some characters. Starts with a boy, a small boy, and his mother. So when the boy, his name is Ernest, he was sitting with his mother outside their cottage. From there both of them could able to see the mountain as well, the face of the mountain. So he asked his mother regarding the mountain. Then the mother told that there is a prophecy. Okay, there is a statement that tells what will happen in the future. Prophecies is made by various villagers that in future there will be a man coming or a person who will be the great and who will be the noblest in that village or in that valley. So this boy, this young boy Ernest, he was very eager to know. He was very interested to meet that person in the future. So he asked his mother, I want also to meet that person who will be the noblest, who will be the greatest in the future. Then further, in the same way, he was very interested when he used to see the great stone face, the little boy, because he could able to see the stone face as every time stone face was giving him a smile. So the boy was very encouraged, and he was every time when the boy completing his work. Okay, Ernest was a boy who was helping his mother in her day to day work with his little hands. He was helping. After completing his helping or the work, he used to sit out of the his hut and used to watch the mountain, and he was watching it continuously and understanding or imagining. He was imagining that the mountain is talking with him. Okay, he is saying something or he is smiling. And gradually he was also getting some different knowledge from the mountain. Okay, because he was not having a teacher, he was not going to school, but in the book it is said that the mountain became his teacher. Mountain was giving him some knowledge in his imagination. But people who were there in that village, they were seeing, when they saw Ernest the young boy who was seeing the mountain continuously, he was watching the mountain. So they called him as a foolish boy who continuously sit and watch the mountain. Then after the days passed, there was a man who, a young man who left the village or the valley and went towards the seashore or the seaport. He settled over there and then he started a business over there, and throughout his life he earned lot of money. It is said that it might take 100 of years for him to count the money, means he was the richest man. So then he thought, that man, particular man, let me go toward my place where I have gone. And he returned back to the village or the valley and he stayed there. So when he returned back, the villagers compared his face as the face of the great stone, that mountain. And all the villagers were ready to accept that this is the noble man, or this is only the greatest man for whom the prophecy was saying. But the young child, Ernest, was not ready with the villagers' thought. Still he was waiting, and as and when he see the mountain was telling him in his imagination that, do not worry, this is not the man or the person who is the noblest and the greatest person is going to come. Then after the days passed, the richest man, his name is, he was doing the business of gold, okay. So when he became old, before dying he lost all his money. And when he lost all his money and when he died, the villagers, people who were there in the village, they changed their thought as the particular man was not the man for whom we were declared the prophecy. Okay, this man is different, that man will come in the future. In this way, daily the boy Ernest was waiting for the person to come, and after completing his daily work, he used to sit and he used to watch the face of the mountain, and he was sitting in his imagination. So after days passed, again there another person was going to come, and another person was a soldier who was working, and he was very hard worker, okay. And when he became a commander, after becoming commander, he also thinks to return back to his native place or the village where he was staying. So when he came back to his village, people, all they gathered and look him, and again they compared him with the face of the great stone, and all the people in the village were ready to accept that this is, or the commander himself is the man for whom they have declared the prophecies. But here again the boy Ernest was not ready to accept the truth, okay. He was still thinking that, as and when he saw the mountain, again the mountain in his imagination said to Ernest that this is not the man, but do not worry, do not get hurt, the man or the person, the noblest and the greatest person is going to come. And in this way, the boy was waiting for that person or the time to come when he is going to meet the greatest person. And the story ends over here. And it is continued in next lesson. We will see the continuation in next lesson. So students, that's all for today. Thank you.